Hello folks, my name is Jason Melius. I'm the historic interpreter here at Fort Dobbs State Historic Site in Statesville, North Carolina. Today I'm going to talk to you about the historic relationship between Fort Dobbs and Bethabara. Fort Dobbs was located near North Carolina's westernmost settlement. It's called the Fourth Creek Settlement. This is about 40 miles west of Bethabara. The fort was built by a company of 50 North Carolina soldiers, and it took them approximately 7 months to build. It was completed around the end of July of 1756. Fort Dobbs served as a garrison for a company of soldiers who, aided by the local militia, patrolled the frontiers of western North Carolina. The fort served as a place of refuge in times of alarm, and it also served as a supply depot for western North Carolina. The Bethabara Diary's first mention of the fort is in relation to a meeting with the fort's commander, Captain Hugh Waddell, which occurred on the 1st of June, 1756, near Salisbury, North Carolina. The Moravians remarked that Waddell was courteous and friendly. Soldiers from the fort passed through Bethabara several times between 1756 and 1761. Most of the time, this is while they were on patrol. However, Captain Andrew Bailey even offered to leave a company of provincial soldiers in Wachovia to aid in their protection during the Anglo-Cherokee War. This offer, of course, was refused. There was an active trade between Fort Dobbs and Bethabara. We have uncovered numerous artifacts at Fort Dobbs, such as mugs and crocks, which were made by Bethabara's potter, Gottfried Aust. The Moravian diaries also relate that Fort Dobbs supplied the Wachovia settlements with weapons and ammunition to aid in their defense. You can learn more about the story of Fort Dobbs by visiting our website at www.fortdobbs.org. You can explore the records of the Moravians in North Carolina, Volume 1, which is available through Bethabara's website. And you can also visit the recreated fort in Statesville. While the facilities are closed due to the pandemic, the grounds and trails are all open for your enjoyment and education. Thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you soon.